focus in on the candles, because the candles are the main part of today's chat. Take two. Whoa! Hello, everybody. It's Erin, and today I'm sick, which is not fun and not helping with the whole video making and being committed to my channel. So that's really fun. Okay, but thank you guys so much. I just want to say thank you for getting me to 20. I didn't even know I was gonna get 20 subscribers. Like, I didn't even expect that. Thank you. I know that's a really low number, and a bunch of people think like 20, what are your goals? I know, but I'm still really happy that I got 20. It's really helped me inside and made me encouraged to really make good videos. I don't even know anymore. We can do this, okay. Today I'm going to be filming a May favorites video, and I haven't filmed a favorites video since February, and I don't usually do them a lot because I usually think they're really boring and they didn't get much views last time, but I'm going to do it again because I didn't really feel like making a more intense video, and this one's really easy to make, and usually I don't have very many favorites that I keep throughout the whole month, but this month I kind of did, so I decided I would make a video. And this is what we're doing. Let's just get started. What is my life? Okay, I don't even know. So first we're going to be starting off with makeup, because makeup is my life, pretty much, you understand. Yeah, the first thing is this mascara, and this is the Maybelline Great Lash Lots of Lashes, mascara, and I love it. I've been not using it for pretty much the whole entire winter, but then I used it again, and I kind of loved it again, and yeah. I love it. I've been wearing it pretty much every day, which is really awkward because I'm not wearing it today because I got a new mascara. I'll be featuring it soon because I'm obsessed with it, so yeah. I love this. We're gonna throw it on our bed today because our bed's this way. The next thing I used more at the beginning of May instead of the end, because as we got further in May, it got a lot more hotter and I realized that I shouldn't be wearing any eyeshadow at all. And what I was wearing was the Maybelline Color Tattoo and Barely Branded. And I really, really liked this. This was amazing. But then I realized, like, not even like a cream eyeshadow I should be wearing. I shouldn't be wearing any eyeshadow or else it's gonna kind of... Yeah, but I wore this. I don't really know what else to say. Okay. Next, I've been wearing all throughout May. I got it at the beginning of May, and I've just been wearing it a bunch. And it's the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, and I know a lot of people talk about this. It's really good. It's really cheap. I, as you guys know, I usually do use the Maybelline Fit Me Powder. But I decided to switch it out also because that's kind of expensive, so I was gonna go on something a little cheaper because I'm cheap. And this was there, and I heard a lot of great stuff about this. I do think it's good. I'm not the kind of person that like understands a powder. Like, this powder is so much better than this powder. OMG, girl, yes. But I'm just kind of not realizing the goodness of the different powders. So this is just like any other powder for me, so it's good, and it's cheaper, so I'll probably stick to this one. Okay, whew, I thought I was gonna open on my bed. I'm like, please don't do that. Oh my god. The next thing is kind of the opposite of the Color Tattoo. I've been wearing it more at the end of May instead of the beginning of May, and it's the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous Foundation. You guys know I wear this. This is like my only foundation that I really use. I love it, and I've been breaking out a bunch because of like the heat, and it's just like not working good on my skin. So it's been nice to use this to cover up, but now we're getting even hotter. I don't know if I should be wearing a foundation. I'll probably stick to a BB cream. BB creams just don't give me the amount of coverage that I usually need. So I've been wearing this, but I'll probably have to stop eventually, which is sad.
Apparently, I didn't want to stick to the trend of being on the bed. I wanted to be on the floor, okay?
The next thing I've just been wearing for the last, like, week, honestly, but I feel like I've been wearing it for a while, so I'm going to add it in this video because I'm just feeling it. It's the e.l.f. Moisturizing Lipstick in Pink Minx, and this is just what it looks like. I've been wearing it a bunch. I don't know, I think it looks really nice on the lips. I never applied it. I was supposed to apply it before this video, but I didn't apply it, so there's my life. How's yours? You can't see me. God, I have a bunch of acne. Okay! I love the color, and no offense to e.l.f. or anything, but e.l.f. is a very cheap line. It's amazing. But sometimes it doesn't get the staying power that I would enjoy in a lipstick, so I want to find something that that's like this exact color, just with something with more staying power. So yeah, but I've been liking it, so it made the video. Congratulations. Okay, that's all for makeup, which is surprising. That was only like what, 20 things. Next, moving on to hair, and hair is something that I don't usually talk about very much on my channel because I'm not obsessed with my hair as some other people are, but this month I've been finding some really good products that I've just been really enjoying in my hair, making me be obsessed with my hair a little bit more than I wish I was, but I kind of like it, and yeah, I'm happy with my hair, and I guess I wasn't obsessed with my hair as much as other people because my hair was not that good, so I didn't really find it to be obsessed with. But I've been loving some products that have been making my hair amazing, making me love my hair, making me want to spend some more money on my hair. First, starting off with shampoo. This is a shampoo that I have been wearing for a while now, but I haven't really been talking about it much because, as I said, I didn't really obsess my hair. But now I've just realized that with the conditioner that I'm about to talk to, it really makes a good match, and I've really been liking the shampoo. And it's the Pantene. I don't know. Is it Pantene or is it Pantene? I'm gonna say Pantene because Pantene sounds kind of stupid. So, Pantene Proven, or Pro-V, I think that stands for Proven. It's the Color Revival Radiant Shampoo. It says Protection plus Hydration plus Vibrant Shine. This is what it looks like because I don't really know how to explain a shampoo. As I said, I'm not very talented in the whole hair type of thing, so we're just gonna show it to you. This what it looks like. It's got some orange and pinkish reddish brownish detailing right here with a little Proven little pill looking thingy, and it says that, and ignore my ratchet nails, hashtag didn't do them for a week. Okay, next is the conditioner, and this is the conditioner I just got this month, and I've really been loving it because I just kind of wanted a conditioner. I wanted the really good one that everyone talks about. I don't remember what brand it's from, but it's the Miracle 10 leave-in conditioner thingy. I really wanted that. It looked super good, but then I got to the store, saw how much it was, and I backed away from it, so that's pretty much what I always do. But I found this, and I kind of grabbed it at the last minute thinking, okay, this looks good enough. I've heard of this brand. I heard it was good, so let's just take it because it was cheap. So I just grabbed it, but I'm really glad that I did grab it because I really enjoy it and I love what it does to my hair. It's the Not Your Mother's Way to Grow Long and Strong Conditioner, Longer Hair, Faster Strengthens Hair Anti-Breaking Formula. Breakage formula. Intense moisturizing for all hair types. I don't know either. But it's from Not Your Mother's, and I've heard they're a really good brand. I have the textured salt sea spray stuff of thingy from them. I don't really notice a difference when I use that, but I feel like I'm not using it correctly, so that's kind of why. But yeah, but I have heard a lot of good things from this brand, and I really like them because of this now. And it says it's supposed to make your hair grow longer. I haven't noticed a complete difference because I've only been using it for a month, but I feel like it has been making a somewhat-ishly difference. I feel it has gotten my hair a little bit longer, but I can't tell it like a dramatic. That, yep. I think it's really good. It's really smoothing and it's amazing, and I recommend it. That's what it looks like. Yep. Okay, good. Close the door. That'd be very nice of you. Rachel, close the door. I love my family. The next thing I want to talk about is a face product, and this is a face product that a lot of people have talked about and a lot of people do love, but I still don't know if I love it or not. But it's the St. Ives Blemish Control Apricot Scrub, and it says it's supposed to prevent blemishes and minimize pores, that word, okay. It's supposed to do that. I don't really know if it does. A lot of people say it does, but I don't. I haven't, like, I've been breaking out when I've been, when I kind of started using this, I started breaking out, but then again, I started using it when it started to get warmer, and I started to sweat a bunch, and my face always does start to break out when it does get warmer, and I start, like, when I start to sweat more, so I don't know if it's because of that or because of this, so I still, I'm still using this, but I don't know if it's really helping or not, so hopefully it is, and it's just, like, the heat, but I don't know. I've got my little flashcards here of all the stuff written down so I don't forget any of it because I tend to forget some stuff. Prepared, study, study. My favorites. There's my handwriting. But now moving on to random favorites. My first random favorites are books. And I have two. It's pretty basic. First of all, The Fault in Our Stars. It was at its biggest trend last year, so I'm very late on it. But it still is an amazing book, and I just kind of started reading it, and I really love it. So if you haven't read it, go read it. It's really good. The other one is Paper Towns, and I kind of read like the first 1/4 of the book, but then I kind of had to stop because I was reading the sample off my phone. And then I had to stop because I didn't want to buy the whole thing. I wanted to get the actual book, and I was going to get it from a friend, but I couldn't get it from my friend. But yeah, so I wasn't able to finish the book, but I really want to finish the book. And I saw the movies coming out, and I saw like the trailer and everything, and I really want to go see it. So, and I kind of watched the trailer, I think like 20 times already, so I love that song also in the trailer. If you haven't gone to see the trailer, go see the trailer. Go see the movie if you're watching this later. Go see it. It's good. I'm probably going to see the movie on the day it comes out because... Squad up. I don't know what that was. Don't ask me because I don't even know. Next is songs, and I don't really have any particular songs. It's mainly just bands. The two bands are Fifth Harmony. I bought like 5 of their songs. They're amazing. I love, like, you can kind of see in my videos I've been using a bunch of their songs lately because I love them. The other band I have been loving is Mr. Wives. I love them. They're amazing. They're great. I love them. Yep, pretty much. Okay. And my last category for favorites is food, and the food I've been loving this month is eggs because I'm cool like that. I've been loving eggs pretty much every single morning. I've been having like any kind of different way of egg that you could cook an egg for like breakfast. I've been having it and I've been loving it. So yeah. So that was my May favorites, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed. I love all the things I said, talked about. And yeah, tell me if you guys like favorites. I personally find favorites a little bit boring because I feel like they're kind of repetitive, because if you watch my videos, you know what I already love because I've been using it in my videos, so I don't really feel a need to make a February favorites. Did I just say that? Oh, I don't really find a need to make a favorites video, but I did because, as I said, I figured I would make it because I had some favorites that I wasn't really talking about on camera. But I've been actually loving them, so I wanted to share them with you guys. And also, as I said, I didn't really feel like editing a video very much, and I just felt like sitting down and talking because I'm bored because it's summer, and I'm already bored, and it was raining today, so you know. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please subscribe. Thank you for 20. I hope I can get a lot more. My goal by the end of the summer is at least 100. Let's try to make that happen. That'd be great. Thank you. So yeah, please subscribe if you haven't already, and like this video, and comment some fun stuff, comment your life down below, comment what you do in the summer, comment your May favorite, and comment other video ideas down below. Don't know what I'm doing with my arms, I don't ever know what I'm doing with my arms, they kind of just go. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Thumbnail time.